Hey, Margaret, is Becker in?
Yeah, he's in his office.
Thanks. So has he called?
Who?
Dan.
No, why would he call?
To tell you what a great time we had on our date, you know? How we went to the game, we held hands, we stayed up all night talking.
Oh, right, I remember. He did call. He told me to tell you to meet him under the bleachers after study hall. See ya.
No, Becker, wait.
If you recall, I have a rule. I don't want to get involved in this, Reg.
Yes, I know, and I respect that. But I think I might really like this guy. So to hell with your rule. Tell me every single thing you know about his ex-wife.
No, just leave me alone, all right?
Becker, he made some comment about how different I was from her. Is it true? Are we different?
No, you're not different.
Why'd your voice go up like that?
It did not.
You just did it again. When people's voices go up like that, they're hiding something.
Don't be silly.
What is it that you don't want me to know about her? Who is she? What does she look like?
You're different, that's all. You're tall, she's not so tall. You own a diner, she doesn't. You know, look, we all have our own strengths, right?
Right. So what are my strengths?
I just told you, you're tall and you own a diner.
Dr. Becker, Mrs. Cohen's waiting for you in room 2. Hi, Reggie.
Hi. Why are you wearing a bedspread?
It's Margaret's and I hate it.
So take it off. Put it back on. Clearly, I have my hands full. You know what I mean. Look. If you and Dan are having a good time, forget about his ex-wife. You know, just leave it alone.
You're right.
Yeah.
I always obsess about stuff like this, and I shouldn't. I mean, who cares about her? I have a lot to offer.
Sure you do.